Hey guys, what's going on? Flipotaku, and today we're doing my manga review for Black Torch. Stay tuned. And before we jump into the review, guys, I want to give a huge shout out to kawaiiness.com. They are an anime, manga, and video game inspired merchandise store with everything from hats, shirts, to anime mouse pads. But they are showing me some love and sponsoring the channel for a handful of videos. And if you use code FLIPOTAKU at checkout, you will receive 15% off your order, free shipping worldwide. So guys, go show them some love because they're showing me some love and I love you guys. So anyways, let's get to the review. Black Torch is a 5-volume battle shonen by Tsuyoshi Takaki, and it is put out by Viz here in the States, and it's under their Shonen Jump banner. And sadly, this is one of those series that got canceled, but a lot of you may be thinking, a canceled series? I don't want to read that. This feels like a complete body of work. What the mangaka has done here, I'm actually really impressed with, because he sets up this world, and the world feels larger than the characters that we're seeing. So the way I interpreted that was that this series was supposed to be a very long, ongoing battle shonen, like a lot of shonen are. But when cancellation came, he had to wrap things up. And honestly, at no point in the 5 volumes of this series that I felt like he was trying to wrap things up. Reading it in one go from volume 1 to volume 5, it felt like a complete story, which is actually really impressive because, like I said, this world feels so big, and the story and the powers and everything felt like there was more to it. But at the same time, I got an ending to a battle shonen. And it never overstayed its welcome. Well, Black Torch is about Jiro and Rago, and they are, Jiro is a human and Rago is a Mononoke, and Mononoke are these powerful, powerful demons that have existed for centuries, and Rago is the most powerful Mononoke that there is, and he is in the form of a cat, which you can, I don't know if you guys can see Volume 1, but he is on the cover of Volume 1. And Jiro and Rago fuse together, which rarely ever happens. It's a huge deal that Rago chose this human to fuse with. And they join the Bureau of Espionage, and especially, I have to get this right, I don't want to mess up the name, the Omnitsu Division, which is the squad called Black Torch. And from there on, they are trying to shut down a series of Mononoke attacks in Tokyo. And I gotta say, this is some of my favorite shonen that I've ever read. And I read a lot of shonen. You guys know I'm a huge shonen fan. I go through these weird phases where I'll read a lot of seinen, and then I'm going through a huge shonen kick once again. And I've read everything from Blue Exorcist to D. Gray Man to Rurouni Kenshin to One Piece, and I've read Bleach, a little bit of Bleach. I've read a ton and ton of shonen. Right now I'm reading Fire Force, I'm reading Black Clover, Lucifer and the Biscuit Hammer. I am going to do a reread again. But this stands out, and I think the reason why it stands out is because it is complete. You get these characters, they're very enjoyable, they don't overstay their welcome, and the humor isn't annoying. That's like my biggest problem when it comes to shonen manga and shonen anime, is that the humor seems forced. There are some humorous parts of this series, but honestly, they're put in at the right time. And the other great thing about the series is the artwork. The mangaka this is some of the best artwork I've seen. As you can tell, the character designs are a little, you know, standard shonen, but when the battles happen, when you start seeing these Mononoke and the designs of them are just so unique and so vibrant, and my eyes could not stop looking at the pages. Also, there are some double spreads, which I rarely see in manga. It's usually like a American comic thing, the double spread. But there are a ton of double spreads. I'll actually show you one real quick. Hopefully I don't get a copyright strike. But yeah, this is a double spread right here at the end of, towards the end of Volume 5. This isn't going to spoil anything. This actually is pretty vague, but there's a lot, and that's probably the worst double spread to show. There are some that are just breathtaking. But when you're reading a battle shonen and you keep flipping and flipping and flipping and you see these beautiful, beautiful double spreads, it's really awesome. Here, I'll show you one more piece of artwork. Look at that character design. Just absolutely insane. Guys, this is one of those mangas where I am just in love with. I'm going to reread this series again. And again, I don't want to jump too much into the story. Like I already told you, Jiro and Rago, they joined the Bureau of Espionage, and they're shutting down these Mononoke attacks. There's a Mononoke who is this gentleman on the cover, who has been around for centuries, and he wants to basically enslave humanity. He lost to humanity at one point in his life, and he never wants to do that again. He realized that humans are weak compared to the Mononoke, but the humans have numbers. Like, we are, like, once we get together and focus as a group, we can overtake even the most powerful of demons. And he starts assembling Mononoke, because usually they are very lone wolf style. And he starts assembling Mononoke, and also he has a power. I'm kind of all over the place, because there's a lot of things that, like, I want to talk about, but I don't want to be super spoilerish, because it is only 5 volumes. But the way that this gentleman is getting more powerful is he is cannibalizing his own kind. And when he cannibalizes them, he is getting their powers. And he wants Rago. And Rago does something that really pisses him off. I don't want to spoil it. But again, guys, if you want a battle shonen that from start to finish is well written, it has beautiful artwork, and it doesn't overstay its welcome, you need to pick up Black Torch. Again, 5 volumes, not a huge time sink, not a huge money sink, and it is refreshing to read a shonen manga where I had no qualms with, like, at all. I didn't have a single problem with this manga. I will say the artwork, and this is a negative, I'm going back on a tangent again about how good the artwork is. The mangaka has this really unique style where as the battles get more crazy and more chaotic, the artwork kind of matches it. His line work is really, really good. So as the things are getting crazier, the line work gets kind of like hectic and all over the place. But then when the more quieter moments, where the more character development's happening, the line work is very calm. And the blacks and the inking in this is just so beautiful. You guys saw some of the artwork. I don't know what he used to draw, but those blacks really pop out on the pages. They're so dark and so vibrant, and I haven't seen anything like it in a very long time. And again, guys, this is getting my highest recommendation. Out of 5 volumes, I give it a 5 out of 5. This is a must-own if you're a shonen fan. Again, if you're not a shonen fan, this isn't going to persuade you to get into shonen. This isn't going to be like the series that you read and go, ah, oh, I'm a shonen fan now. No, this is a series for shonen fans, and it is written that way, and it really pays off. This is a phenomenal, phenomenal battle shonen. And again, I'm sad that it's over, but I'm happy that it didn't overstay its welcome. And this mangaka, I believe this is his first work, and I hope we see something from him in the future. After every volume, there is a little afterword from him, and he seems like a very nice person. He seems very grateful that he even got the chance to have his books published. And again, shout out to Viz for putting this out in English, because this is one of my favorite series now. Not of all time, but of 2019, at the end of the year, I just made my favorite ongoing manga list. At the end of the year, when I make my favorite series of 2019, this is going to be on that list. This is one of the more refreshing reads I've read all year, and I highly recommend you guys pick it up. But anyways, guys, I'm Flipotaku. Thank you for watching, and guys, we're so close to 2,000 subscribers. That just blows my mind, so please show some support, guys. If you guys are coming from this, if you guys are watching this review and you're not already subscribed, please do. It really means a lot to me. I have a bunch of content coming. I got my first impressions for Ryuko, Witch Atelier. I'm looking over there. A couple of light novel reviews. I got a bunch of stuff going on. So anyways, subscribe down below. At 2,000 subscribers, I might do another giveaway. But I do have some more sponsorships lined up. So please, guys, remember, go to quietness.com. Use promo code Flipotaku at checkout, and you will receive 15% off your order. Anyways, guys, I'm Flipotaku, and I'll see you guys next time.